Hey guys, I'm Wyatt Miller. I'm Slingshot's windsurfing and wingsurfing brand manager. We're down here in Baja California, Mexico to give you a little run through of the new Wingcraft line. This is our wing specific line we've been working on for the last couple of years. Super happy with how these boards came out. They're all a blast to ride. Even like the big 120 for me, we were testing it with Fred Hope, one of our kite foil team riders, and both of us are like, we could have a blast on this board. Like I could ride this thing and pump it all day long and have a total blast. Great sizes. So we got 120 liters, that's 6 foot by 29 wide. We got the Wingcraft 90 liters, which is 5'6" by 27 wide. Then you get down to the 75 liter, which is what I'm using pretty much all the time. It's 5 foot by 25 wide. And then you got the smallest one, the 60 liter down there. That's 4'8" by 24 wide. All the boards are really nice and thick. Even the smallest one is 4 inches wide. I believe the 75 there is 4.5 inches wide, and it gets thick, and it gets wider from there. Nice beveled rails, which really help with touchdowns. You got a lot of scoop in the tip of the nose. I find this saves me constantly in touchdowns or when I'm landing a move and I'm a little too heavy on my front foot. It really kind of porpoises and comes back up, this extra scoop right there. All the boards come with both a tri-foot strap option and an offset front foot. We have a lot of people who are coming over to the sport, new to wind sports from the surfing discipline, and they're only used to going 1 foot forward, so they really like this offset centered front foot. Those of us who are coming over from the wind disciplines are used to going both ways, switching our feet, so that tri-strap comes in really handy. Lots of hole patterns there to choose from, different widths. I'm usually all the way back with my back foot and one from the farthest forward with my front foot. And I have, you know, our little 12-year-old protégés much more pinched, but the foot strap options really work good for everybody. On the bottom here, you'll see that we got the bottom carry handle, which is absolutely crucial. I don't understand how anybody can get out of the water, into the water with shore break and keep their wing intact without this bottom handle. It allows you to have hold the bottom handle so you can hold your foil and your board in one hand with the foil pointing upwind, your wing pointed downwind, nice and safe and far away from your foil to get in and out of shore break. Absolutely crucial there. And next little design feature that we're stoked with is these windsurf style track mounts. So these, the big hole in the back there allows you to put your whole pedestal on and take your whole pedestal off without removing the track hardware from the pedestal. So you can leave the nuts and bolts in the pedestal, you pull up the back sides, drop the front two in, slide it forward, drop the back two in, and you can get the whole thing in and out without trying to line up all the holes, which is really nice when you're all excited to get onto the water. You got the nice tail cut out here, really helps you break free and pump that board off of the water. Yeah, and the beveled rails really help with touchdowns, and that nice scoop right towards the end of the nose really helps when you're landing tricks and coming down a little too hard on your front foot or saving some touchdowns. Another thing we did after the first round of prototypes was we put a couple extra wraps of carbon on the rails. In wingsurfing, we're all climbing onto the board from the rail, putting our knees, our harness bars, right onto that rail, so that can be, you know, a wear point. We noticed that early, put a couple extra wraps of carbon there, so it's really reinforced on that upper rail. So again, you don't put your knees, it doesn't go soft as you're climbing on and off 6,000 times, which happens in this sport. 120 is what I start most people off on at my wingsurfing resort down here in Baja. It's nice and stable, 29 wide. Most people can get up onto their knees and feel pretty comfortable. We do have some people who start right away on the 90 liter. You know, people who are coming from a windsurfing background, they can really make this 90 liter work. And we're seeing the transition between the 120 and the 90 happen pretty quickly for people. So if you think you got a lot of really good balance, you know, you come from a wind sports background, you might be able to just jump onto this Wingcraft 90. If it's your first board ever and maybe you're a little new to the sport, we definitely go with the 120 liter there. I'm 90 kilos, 200 pounds. The Wingcraft 75 is perfect for me. That's the biggest board I ever really need to use. You know, at 75 liters, it's true. If the wind is totally dead and I have no forward momentum at all, it is gonna sink under me. However, I can get to my knees on it and it stays on the surface of the water, which is really important. And then with any power in the wing, I stay on the surface of the water. With the 60 liter at 90 kilos, I need a little bit more wind to get it going. As I climb to my knees on that 60 liter, it is gonna sink under the water, you know, about a foot, and I'm gonna need some pull in the wing to get up onto the surface of the water and go. So if the wind is super light, that 60 is gonna be a little small for me. The 75 for me at 90 kilos, 200 pounds, that is the biggest board I would ever really need to use. We got some of our other team riders are more like 70 kilos, 155 pounds, and that 60 liter works perfect as their lightest wind board, stays on top of the surface of the water, and you know, with any pull in the wing, they're gonna keep that thing on the surface and be able to pop right up onto a foil. So it's a great line. There's a size in there for everybody. Even the biggest one is just agile and pumpable and fun, even for people like Fred Hope. Don't pay attention to the foot strap inserts on this 120. It's pre-production. This is the insert pack that you'll see that gives you the tri-strap option and offset front foot. Great boards. I kind of want them all.